Welcome to the LZ of the day. Oh my goodness. Look at that flag. We got a nice breeze from the water. It's actually a pretty good temperature too now. 729, so it's 730. Good breeze from the lake, which is a good sign. There is nothing for miles over here. Look at him go. He's so happy. Hi, buddy. Hi. Hi. Okay, well, I think it's time to start getting some gear out. I think it's time to start going flying. Zeus, you run wild, bro. I'll find you.
When you're on a holiday. Come on, Mike. You got this, buddy. Run. Hit the throttle. Hit the throttle.
Well, I'm not gonna waste any time. Onward to the mountains. Well, well, well. We have made it to the Mountione. Not very high up here. I'm gonna be super conscious of rotor given we had near reverse launchable conditions. So I'm gonna take it nice and easy for the boys. I'm also flying a brand new wing to me. So we're gonna take it a little extra easy on it. Oh yes. Look at this. Oh baby. Yes sir. Got a small amount of lift up here. Fly guy. I just love to be up in these hills. Even if I'm not that high, I just love to be up in these hills. The views, the mountain, the terrain, the everything about it is just so freaking fun. So freaking fun. If you want to learn how to mountain fly, I do offer an advanced training class. That's all I'll say about it. Link in the description if you want to learn more. It's actually pretty smooth up here. I'm not getting rocked around. I'm not getting bumped around, which is good. Just reaching the top of this hill. Whoa, there's some lift. There is a little bit of lift. This wing definitely feels a little funky monkey when we get into lift and actually when we get into brakes. I'll be interested to kite this wing and see what I think of it when I do that, because that's typically a good sign or a good indicator of how it handles under brake pressure, how it stalls, how easily it recovers from the stall. If it's flyable with a partial collapse, how easy it collapses and it will fly you. Kiting a wing actually tells you a lot. I highly suggest you kite any and every wing you ever try. So I plan to do that with this bad boy. Maybe tonight if the point of the mountain is good. If not, another time. Oh yes, sir. This is crispy. It is gully. So cool, dude. Mountain flying is so freaking fun. I want to go fly Tipitogas this sometime here soon, too. It's that mountain all the way over there looking just absolutely dreamy. But I can actually see for the first time Pelican Point. I don't know what it's called. But right there is a place where bunch of birds just hang out. And it's like a little island that I never knew about until I was watching some bush plane pilots talk about landing there. And I was like, oh, hey, that's a thing, which is kind of neat. Oh, right off the edge. Tip drag the tree? Come on, man. Let's just rip this gnarly line, though. Ooh, bumpy. It's bumpy. Look at these two. Two sexy freaking Dominators. Black and white and red and white. Can't go wrong with those two colors, boys. Can't go wrong. That black and white just, black and white just looks crispy and clean. That red and white just is the original OG color. What's poppin', boys? Oh, I'm dragging the boys to the mountains. I think they're freezing. They're all geared up in like two pants and three jackets. I'm in one shirt, one jacket, and a pair of sweats. These boys can't handle the cold. They can't handle the cold, so we'll only play on the foothills. But I want them to get up in here and kind of feel it out and see what we're looking at. There's a little bit of turbulence, so I'm sure it'll freak out Mike just a smidgey. I was scouting out this place as a possible fly camping location right here. It actually looks pretty good, other than the launching doesn't look too ideal. Landing looks fine. I mean, that looks crispy landing. I could set it down right now. I've got wind. I like this spot. I like this spot a lot, actually. I'm gonna flip it around here in just a sec and get the feels going into the wind. Oh, I like this spot a lot. This might be the fly camping spot of the future. I feel like setting her down. If I get a good reading on wind, then I'm gonna go for it. I'm not really seeing these bushes move at all. Feeling a little bit. That tree doesn't look like it's moving. Pro tip, birds typically always land into the wind. So if you're not sure, just land with the birds. This looks not bad. Looks not bad. It's a little bit rocky right there. Definitely rocky right there. But there are some good runways back up in there. Let's get a second gander. Let's see, we're gonna go out to the left. So there's definitely some smooth spots in here. Could totally stick her down. Back in my heyday, I would have already landed. A little more risk conscious these days. I feel like the wind is not. I'm not 100% sure where that wind is coming from. Kind of drifting left. Almost makes me think it's right. Could totally see this being an epic fly camping spot. If I was on my trusty Dominator, I would have already set it down. Oh yeah, this is the fly camping spot. I found it. That's it. That's the spot, bruh. You can't hear me. But that's where we're going fly camping, is right there. I like that. Oh, getting a little lift right there. And these high aspect ratio wings, man. Don't break, they definitely have a feel to them. I think it's time to descend in elevation to cool, to warm up a little bit, not cool down, because I am cold. Hopefully I didn't film that all in 1080p. I'm gonna be pissed off if I did, but that was a good flight. Only about 45 minutes up and around Lake Mountain before we froze. There's an SIV going on over there, which is kind of slick. I was test flighting the Dudek Warp. That was my second time ever flying it. First time I only flew for like 15 minutes before the weather just got gnarly. This is like the first day we've had in weeks where we actually had good conditions. So it was super fun to get out here and actually get some flying in. I'm stoked about it. I actually see another person getting towed right there. You guys probably can't see them. But anyways, I'm gonna go chat with the boys. We're gonna enjoy our morning. We're gonna go back and get some work done. I know, lame, right? Who'd like to go back and do any work after you just flew? And we'll catch you guys in the next video. Thank you.